I just want to win. Winning gets you everything in this league, so I just want to be labeled as a winner.
What a play by Derrick!
I'm not worried about no triple doubles. As long as we win.
Oh my goodness! I want to go higher.
I just want to be the best player out there.
Do you know who this kid is? He's from Chicago. He has a 40-inch vertical. This is why this kid's special. This kid is special.
You just run to your spot, and that time Barbosa got to his spot. The patience of Steve Nash found him.
Heinrich. A deep jump shot. Now this is drives in. Shot rejected by Noah. Chicago 2-on-1. Heinrich up top and there is Rose at the cup to slam it in with two hands. 1-8, lost 5 in the last 13.
Just 2-on-1 and Heinrich puts it on point and Rose does the rest. I like what the Bulls are doing. So many teams come in here and try to slow the game down and get out of character. Do offensively is predicated on Steve Nash making plays off of pick and roll in transition as Derrick Rose scores over him. It's all about Heinrich falls asleep. The delivery to Nash is paid the price.
Jared Dudley on the floor as well for Phoenix. As Rose leans in off balance on the run and again hits that jump shot, Mark, out there from the elbow.
So you put the time in, you have a license to take that jump shot. Here's a guy that shot to the shooters of this Phoenix Suns team.
Deck drives and kicks. A one dribble adjustment to his left gets him some airspace over Nash and he hits another one out there.
Gotta make Steve Nash defend. Hosting up Derrick Rose. Help has to come quick.
Rose again hits that jump shot again from the left elbow. Loves that spot. Barrier numbers. Solomon's the other way. Skip pass gathered in by Rose, who again will pump a jumper and again knocks it down. Nothing but net. Rose 7 for 9. And so he heads to Dallas. This fellow right here, though, Derrick Rose, won't be long before he'll be on that All-Star team. What kind of case can you make for him this year on that All-Star team? Rose is 8 for 10 tonight. He has been deadly with that mid-range shot. Here he comes, breaking down Barbosa on the dribble. A one-hander over the oncoming defense, up and in.
That's bad D by the Suns. They decided to go zone and still allow penetration by Rose.
Steve Nash had a moment. But it was Derrick Rose in the first half that leads the Chicago Bulls. Rose hitting 9 of 11 and Chicago at half with the lead.
Started. I'm not satisfied because my team, it seems like they've taken their foot off the gas pedal.
But Rose banks it in from distance just inside the three-point perimeter.
Vinny Del Negro looked at his guys and yelled, play through it. Basically, he's saying, hey, we knew adversity would come at some point in this game. Let's continue to play and play confidence. And that's how you do it. Put the ball in the hands of Derrick Rose and trust that he's going to make a play. This is a big-time play. What it does is it does not allow Derrick Rose to break down the interior of their defense.
Suns' first lead since 13-11. And Rose glides in, rearranges, and lays it softly in.
And that's a good adjustment.
Suns have come out here in the third. Coupled with Steve Nash's fine floor play, Grant Hill scoring, and the zone defense, they've scrambled back in. Luol Deng, however, puts the Bulls back in the lead with a three.
But Derrick Rose by any other name. Good ball movement, good man movement. He's having his way.
To bring it in. Rose will take it. Rose with two. Rose with one. A three is in the air, and he got it! Derrick Rose at the buzzer. Ending the third quarter, Rose has been outstanding. 27 points for Rose, and the Chicago Bulls take a 5-point lead here in Phoenix to the fourth quarter.
We talk about Derrick Rose putting the time in to get better as far as a jump shooter in this league. Certainly feeling comfortable and confident with his ability to knock down the jump shot. No question about it. Certainly got it off before the light went off and also the buzzer. Derrick Rose put on a clinic. 27 big points. His team up 5. Outstanding job of setting the tone and stopping the
move. Right back outside to Richardson. Nice in. Ball stripped away by Heinrich. Thomas. And Derrick Rose brings down the Thunder with a two-hand jam. Oh! Way, way above the rim.
Goodness, Dragic, allow me to introduce you to Derrick Rose. Mama, there goes that man. Big time finish by Rose. Wow, that's a point guard. That's a point guard cocking it back and dunking.
Take a look. Avoid that backboard at all costs. Let's go to Mark Jones. 20 left, leading by 8, and the ball in Rose's hands with 8 to shoot. Trying to draw a foul. He pumps it in. He was looking for contact from Nash. Nash backed off, and Rose double clutches and hits. 15 of 21 tonight, 32 points.
Why not? Derrick Rose putting on a clinic. Simply says, I know your work, Steve Nash. I know exactly who you are, but it's my time now. Get in the air and take this. Derrick Rose having himself.
Youngster doing Derrick a terrific Rose. Job, handing out 5 assists as well. Up next on ESPN and SportsCenter, this has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Mark Jackson and our entire crew, Kevin Calabro, saying so long from Phoenix, Arizona. Derrick Rose to Noah, who finishes down the other end, and a good start for Chicago.
Spread the floor more. O'Neal can get centers in foul trouble and provide an offensive rebounding presence. I think they have a much...
So the rebound, and here comes Rose, who last year in that 7-game series against the Celtics started off with a 36-point game. Difficult year it was with the Wizards. Now he's playing for a championship. Tough shot from Derrick Rose.
I love, so it's not about individual stuff. It's about when I call on you, be ready. It's about a team with one mission, one goal.
Wow, what a move from Rose right there. Pretty play, but his team's still down by 14. And here comes Rose. Rose, the burst of speed up and under. Boy, is he fun to watch. As was James' defense down the
guy can score. He can pass, he can rebound, and as Rose makes it, and the element he has that
didn't come until his 7th year in the NBA. James has had one NBA Finals appearance. That was back in 2007 when they were swept by the Spurs. Play now. Shot clock at 7. Rose jump shot gets that one to go. Hope to make the playoffs. He was out of character when he guaranteed they would make the final playoff spot. Makes a pretty move there. And it's a 12-point game.
Got a little quiet.
Rose, little hesitation, flips it up. And oh, what a play from Derrick Rose. 12 straight points, and it's a 10-point game.
I can't see how he would not win the next, like, 5, 6, 7 in a row.
You're not kidding. Rose with another nice floater. He's hit a couple of really tough shots here in the third.
You can't say it.
Single-handedly to keep them in the game on the offensive end.
Pick and roll situations, got into the thick of things, and had to find a way to begin to score the basketball. Rose finding Deng, slashing to the hoop, and Rose has been spectacular all game long. Getting into the seams, taking pressure off everybody else, and making plays.
Rose looking, drives, pulls back, tough shot. Rose knocks it down. He's got 24 plus 10 assists.
Well, again, Derrick Rose had the ball in his hands for multiple dribbles here. Got space with the step back.
Time, but not for the effort from Derrick Rose. Not shooting well, but he's got 26 points, 10 assists, 7 rebounds. Bulls fought hard in the second half after falling behind by 22, but the Cavs just too
slim down, Shaquille O'Neal. Here's Rose, yes. And we saw Derrick Rose come up big last Trailblazers.
Andre Miller put on a show last night, especially in that end of that third and fourth quarter, as Derrick Rose starting to find his offense here in this first quarter.
In this playoff run, there's no room for mistakes, and he'll be damned if he's going to make the mistake.
And he's playing against Noah. Here's Rose. Yes.
Derrick Rose,
who had a terrific month of passing there. Joe Keenan, as Noah gets inside and does it again.
Line on his outside shot, and on the flip side, Derrick Rose, 28 points in game one, but 7 turnovers tonight, 12 points and 0 turnovers, and doing a good job of also slicing the defense, but if you back off of him, can knock down the outside shot as well.
Saw Joakim come out early before the rest of his teammates as Rose is able to knock it down, and Joakim was working on that out. Parker. Rose looks to split through. Rose with a terrific second effort. What a move by Derrick Rose, and the Bulls lead.
Back. Derrick Rose is in this same category. Look at the split here. And this is between two pretty good defensive guys, and Anthony Parker and Antoine Jameson just getting to there to be the All-Star.
The second effort by James, and then Rose right back. So the Cavaliers now lead it 80s high by James, recovered by Noah. Nice pass, and Rose able to get it off. Rose, yes. But the Cavaliers now lead by 8.
Walked out at Michael Jordan's facility here.
Oh, nice move by Rose. He was a blur, whipping by Mo Williams. O'Neal and another bad pass.
Nice crossover there by Derrick Rose, taking the ball to the...
And as Vinny Del Negro said, nice pass from Noah. Rose again!
And that's what I'm talking about, the vision of Joakim.
Just under 6 left in this first quarter, and the Bulls up by 3.
Shoulder, even though it was deflected, for him to see Jameson.
Derrick Rose. Good start for Rose. He has 8 points. He's at 3 of 5.
Michael Phelps and almost beat him, or no?
No, I don't. Oh, beautiful shot by Rose. I think he lost every event that he was involved in. He was always given
a shot. Already 3 of 6 for 7 points. And in the lane, the little teardrop from Derrick Rose.
Quarter, getting it going. And what I've liked about him, the crossover here, you get into the paint. Now remember, we set only 6 total free throws in this series so far. A little give and go from Noah, and then the floater in the lane. You've got 4 defenders of Cavs around you.
Out of 2, Rose has to fling it. And hits! A fling 3.
The shot clock running down here, just trying to get up, trying to get it up on the rim right here.
Discussion before. Rose, he's feeling it. 6 of 8, 15 points. Cavaliers will hold for 8.
In the first half, not really settling for a lot of jumpers, and if the defense is going to be last, nice little crossover dribble right here, using that little floater runner in the lane, and when the defense does back off of you, being able to knock down the open jump shot. And on the flip side, LeBron James.
Rose with a little push shot.
It's not necessarily a runner or a floater. It's almost like a little push shot. Attack the basket, and that's exactly what the Bulls are doing.
Rose. This time, Derrick Rose goes glass. Mike Brown calls for time.
Change of scenery, change of venue. Different result. He's young.
Here's Rose. Tough angle shot by Derrick Rose. That's a 2. Had a foot on the line. Try to trap Rose. Rose again with an unusual release. Kevin Holland, Doug Collins will have it for you. We've got about 5 minutes to go here in the fourth. Rose again. A spinner by Derrick Rose. Rose. Met by Parker. Here's Rose with that push shot. That's the 3rd time tonight we've seen that shot. He's hit all 3.
He should market it.
Rose. Yes. Got the step on James and was able to pull up for that side.
Off that great start. And the transition game is making a beautiful pass to Deng, running hard on the break. The mid-range game is there for Derrick Rose. He already has 3 field goals. But what you like is the tempo. The tempo is Chicago. Deng
trailed by 3 here in game 4. And the NBA playoffs will continue after this message. And a word. Bounds already. 21-11 there on rebounding the Cavs as Rose gets inside and scores.
Mike, one of the very few fairly because the Cleveland defense is back so well. This is a good, strong move right here. They forced Rose to change
their 11 of their 13 playoff games. That 23 is the big reason why. And Cleveland fans hope their 23 will rewind.
Yeah, and he understands it. He's an excellent passer and a good high post player.
Heinrich.
A 3. Go.
He comes to get it from Miller. He's short. Look at Rose go up and get it. And get another one. The quarters, well, 16-5. Cleveland on a run here at the back end of the second. Rose sees 2 defenders and scores anyway up over them.
I like
Rose trying to make something happen. Reverse
using the rim to get Shaq out of the way.
And it's had a great season. It was beautiful to watch. I thought the people were terrific.
Yeah, they always are, too, as Derrick Rose scores to make it a 20-point game. That's
better from the free throw line.
That's impressive preparation by you. Rose knocks it down inside the arc.
Like it or not, Jameson, you are the number two player on this team.
Oh, the acceleration. Derrick Rose attacking the hoop.
Rose, the star guard of the Bulls this morning, if the team was at all concerned about Del Negro's future, and he said
he's done everything that's been asked of him, and if I was in his position and one of my star players, as Derrick Rose gets one, another one to go down from the outside, if my star player tells me I want to play.
Free throw line when we come back. This is a part of Derrick Rose's game that has absolutely improved year one to year two. The perimeter skills. 2-point game here in Cleveland.
To the floor with that three.
Cleveland has 10 field goals, 8 assists. Rose hanging in the air. That is a terrific move by Derrick Rose.
Rose is only going to get better.
4 seconds to play. Opening quarter. Jamario Moon has come on for Cleveland. Rose gets around him, and that floater is a lethal weapon for Derrick Rose.
I always tell people, speed kills, and Derrick Rose has the total package when it comes to that department.
Chicago, shot clock down to 10. Using the screen from Noah, Rose over Varejao, book it.
And what I like about the Bulls also in this first.
Their first double-digit lead. Rose, count it, Derrick Rose.
Him even more dangerous when he's a facilitator and everyone else is being able to knock down jumpers is Derrick Rose. He's having that he can bring to your team and get you to the bonus early. And keeping the Bulls in this game has been Derrick Rose's ability to get to the basket. Here in the switch situation, Virgil's a little bit late closing out to him. Derrick Rose gets into the paint with that.
Game two where the Bulls dominated a lot of the categories, but they were behind at the half as Rose knocks in a two.
Cut it to four. Just over 2 minutes gone by in the third. Rose lines it up. And he knocks it down. It's a three.
Very opportunistic.
Rose with a head of steam. Floater goes down. Derrick Rose and
the Bulls switched that pick and roll, and Shaq was guarding Rose.
Rose on a stutter step. Oh, that is special. Derrick Rose getting to the hoop. Timer is down to 8. Count it, Derrick Rose! Oh, what a maneuver! And a chance at a 3-point play.
Here, look at this pick and roll. Just split. Big fella comes over, gets a little bit of the knee, does not put the basketball back down. And the reaction there between his backcourt mate as Shaq picks up his 5th foul.
Boy, this year, Jeff.
You can make the case Derrick Rose is in the MVP consideration and the most improved player. His numbers have skyrocketed play and really no backup 4-5 that they actually trust. He's really done a great job in giving them every game production.
And here's another reason why Rose scoring so much more this year. He's become.
I think he doesn't have to have the same respect for the game as some others because he wasn't very respectful as Derrick Rose. Great offensive rebound. And Mike, usually you don't want your point guards on the offensive board. Here, Derrick Rose goes up over Pau Gasol. And then great effort by Taj Gibson to come back in and rebound the ball.
Nice left-hand move from Rose. So powerful going to the basket so far.
Well, this is Chicago's best offense. Get Derrick Rose into the open court.
Rose, good open three. Knocks it down.
But it all started by posting up Carlos Boozer.
Rose trying to shake. And he's down. Hits a three. The Bulls struggling.
Next week, if they can win tonight, they're going into their next week, that homestand with both Boston and Miami.
Nice pass. And how about this? The game is tied. The Bulls with a rebound. Boy, has the momentum changed. Rose in attack mode. Up and under. Oh, he banks it in. What a play from Derrick Rose. Derrick Rose, he is fun to watch.
I mean, the ability to balance up, step through, adjust.
Which is where he is. Really have turned him around. Final seconds of the half. Rose, one-handed, throws it down.
An ugly first half But Derrick Rose looked beautiful because of his variety of skills offensively. The three-point shot here, the incredible offensive rebound and finish. And then the creativity on the break in transition. And then finally the little floater over the top of the length of the players. But he learned his craft and it was difficult. As Rose, nice bounce pass to Boozer, forced the pick and roll to the baseline. So you see Fisher up on the top side. Odom's there to support, and just a great pocket bounce pass, exceedingly well.
Rose, dang, a three. What's it in? Rose sets up, fires a three-pointer, and puts it in. And Derrick Rose now with 17. It's the first.
Look at this, Mike. He's going into his back-end game. Fisher comes down right off the dribble. If you hit him long.
Season. Boozer tied up. Rose will try another three. It's good. Derrick Rose, 3 for 4 from downtown.
Well, they're running the pick and roll. They find a little pocket. Boozer likes to drive left, sucks the defense in, and then finds a spot.
They didn't have any in the third. Rose line drive. 22 for Rose. Right ahead of him, he's got Dominique Wilkins, Oscar Robertson, Akeem Olajuwon, Urban Hayes. That shot's good from the corner. They're going to review it on the court. They count it as a two. There's chance of MVP for Rose. Korver for three. Bang! Let's see the Rose. Yeah, that's a two. You saw that left foot on the line.
But, Mike, he made one of these shots against Houston, as we see him kicking it to Korver for the three on the pick and roll to tie the game, the same sort of thing. Full speed, being able to.
8 straight points by Chicago. Rose to the basket, left-handed lays it in.
Well, it's a great split by Rose, but then to be able to adjust, go off the wrong foot.
Rose lost it momentarily. Noah. Rose drives, pulls up, jumper, puts it in. Oh, Derrick Rose again.
Wow. Poor possession. Clock running down. Splits the double team. Step back to his left. Off bounce.
There's a shot clock down to 4. Derrick Rose gets inside on his first shot with a beauty.
And you have to go at Rondo defensively. If you just let him roam far too often.
Dallas had a dozen offensive rebounds in that game.
Rose, nice feed to Noah. Oh, what a pretty pass from Derrick Rose. And the Bulls sharp to start. And here comes Rose. Rose to the basket. Inside to Dang, and an easy finish. Nice sequence from the Bulls, who go up by 8. Make shots consistently.
But when you have Derrick Rose pushing it like that and making plays, you're going to get good quality shots. Good catch by Dang. Easy finish.
They lead by 8. You can see already lifting off that left foot. And then on the next play, planting on the left foot. And he looks okay so far as we check in for the first time tonight with Rick Bucher. Hey, Rick.
Thank you, Mike.
Finding him for the three-point shot.
Pierce, by the way, with tonight ties Kevin McHale for third all-time as Boozer hits another.
Pierce now. Well, Boozer's off to a terrific start. Again, you have to close down his airspace, make him put it on the floor. Very good pick-and-roll receiver knocking in the mid-range jump shot.
Off. Rivers trying to be patient with this team as they get themselves together and trying to get in rhythm this season. Rose knocks down the jumper. You know, we said this is Rivers' 8th season. Unlike Tom Thibodeau, who was an assistant for 21 years, Doc
about
Rivers
to do
became
that too. They search him out.
Rose kicks it into Boozer, and Boozer looked like he got whacked.
You mean the human? You don't think human psychology impacts?
Oh, absolutely.
Dang.
Luol Dang. What a sensational defender he is. Ball. Wilcox pokes it. Rose right back and throws it down. And the lead is ballooned to 19. Derrick Rose and the Bulls in command here in Boston tonight in the NBA. Chicago Bulls' best record in the NBA, 10-2, including 6-2 on their road, having their way with the Celtics here in Boston. Halftime at the TD Garden, Bulls by 19.
Everyone for Lynn's Craft. If you could take a guy off any park and make him have this type of vision, Lynn's Crafter, here we come. Look, I mean, he's going full speed to be able to make the right play. You know, basketball is simple. It's about when to pass and when to shoot. Derrick Rose knows when to pass and when to shoot. Thus,
Kevin
the game
guy
is easy.
Wants to do that when his career ends.
Yeah, it really is hard. Very few guys.
Look at Rose. And a foul. Off a bad miss, stays with the play, offensive rebound, and now can make a three-point play.
This is the second time he has made a bad play look spectacular. Just heaves it off the backboard, continues to go get it, and now has the possibility.
You're minus 15 in rebounding tonight. Taj Gibson connects. Gibson's second field goal.
Remaining third quarter.
Rose the drive. Tough shot. That's some contact as well there.
Bradley, by the way, he's a very good defender for a young player.
Rose blows by him, though, and puts it in. What a shot from Rose.
Just the body control to avoid the congestion. Takes on Garnett. Slides by Jermaine O'Neal.
Look at Rondo. Trying to harass, leaves Rose open for three, and he knocks it down. Doc Rivers not happy with Rondo there. One shot technical.
Well, they're in a scramble out of the zone and out of the second shot that was created, and then Rondo gambling on.
And the Bulls holding off the Celtics right now.
Well, a furious charge, and Rose, a great finish to his right. And then even sometimes when he misses, it's good offense because it frees up the bigs for second shots, and then exquisite body control as he slides by. And after missing his first four threes, knocks in a big all company.
Brewer. Rose straight on three. Again, Derrick Rose back-to-back threes. And the Bulls back up by nine, their largest lead of the fourth quarter. 14, big number. Rose drives. Banks it in. Oh, beautiful play from Derrick Rose. And it's an 11-point lead. 12 points in the fourth quarter.
Just the body control. The strength. I mean, that's just play of the day, man.
Kind of true to form, what we've seen with them all during this win streak.
Rose, Boozer. High Archer, nothing but the bottom.
That's going to be a tough matchup for Ilgauskas. That was a big-time rebound over Ilgauskas.
Rose driving, windmills a shot. Oh,
that's
scores.
Nice. As he turned the corner right there. Once he lowered that shoulder right there, Ilgauskas was in trouble. Watch it right here. He turns the corner. Bosch can't guard him, and he just goes from one side to the other. Could have easily been a foul right there.
Stolen by Kurt Thomas. Here comes Rose. Weaves his way in, then kicks it out. Dang, dribble drive, got it.
Good move by Luol. Dang.
Heels in, nice move, but then stripped. Here comes Rose. He flashes in, and the layup's good.
Oh, again, he's coming at you full speed. I don't care if you're Dwayne Wade, LeBron James, and he's got you below the free throw line. You are in trouble.
Gets the ball back, and then had it rejected.
Good defense.
Here comes Rose.
Trouble.
Right in, and that's goaltending.
Trouble.
And a foul.
I tell you, it's trouble. Once he gets you backpedaling, it is right here. This is all set up by the block. D. Rose gets Chalmers reaching, and then right there you see the goaltending right there by Howard.
Wade missed only two regular season games this year. Boozer inside, making Miami pay. Luol to Rose, the run killer. Gibson and Luol play catch. Loop, fan down underneath to Rose, shot up and good.
They needed
good
that
movement
bucket.
Off the ball by Rose.
They needed that bucket right there.
Here's Dang, and outside Rose for three. Got it.
I'll tell you what, when he's hitting that shot, we talked about it last night. Going out rotating, leaves a smaller guy on the backside.
Kurt Thomas had a wide open rebound. There it is. You don't want him to start hitting up from distance.
He knocked that down, and that suddenly you'll find Stacey King at the United Center in Chicago. Rose, the drive and the kick. Good night.
There you go.
Bogans from Rose.
Again,
Rose. Oh, he's loose in the lane. Down the lane, scooping, scoring.
Oh, too big, too strong, too fast, too good. This boy is an all-star, should be a starter. Get out there and vote D. Rose. Here it is right here. Just look at the athleticism. And again, right now, Miami just wants to try to buy some time until they're able to get Dwayne Wade back in the game.
Rose inside. No, Rose's own rebound. Back up with the other hand and score.
Oh, just goes right over the top of the Miami defenders. Second chance points, 22-6. Big advantage by the Bulls.
Chalmers, they couldn't get a shot away. Now Chalmers at drive.
Oh, he just got it blocked. Good defense by the Bulls. Now watch Derrick Rose, and he gets the contact, and he goes right back up, and he goes over and Joel Anthony, who's a shot blocker.
And shoots it with his arm
now and try to post up.
Rose to Dang. Contact, but he scored anyway.
That was a good basket cut right there. Some post presence, but also Kurt Thomas, he's a guy that can knock down a little jump shot.
Rose, jumper right over Eddie House.
Eddie House just too small.
They wanted to fan that to Wade. Here's House. That's blocked by Rose.
Rose to block.
Did he get up? Watch this.
Watch House. He thought he had a shot. Here it is right here. Derrick just comes out of nowhere. Just elevates. Uses that 40.
Rose down the lane. Score!
This is a man's game. No boys allowed. This is a man's game, Funk.
92-90. He's got him back to within a field goal. Now Rose. His turn to go to work. Ducks, fires, got it!
Give it to me! Give it to me! Up and under. Mario Chalmers, stay on the floor. Don't go for the eyebrow fake.
Oh my goodness. And even though he was hit.
Now watch the drive right here as he just blows right by Chalmers. And again, just blows by him, elevation scores. And that's why it's a superstar player right here, shows up. Up and under, and one, splash.
He at the top of his game. James was waiting that time for Rose, who steps back and knocks down.
So far, mainly they gave up 16 threes against Orlando and 17 against San Antonio.
Four of their last five. Boozer double, skip to Korver. Rose fakes a three, takes a better two.
I like Korver. Keep them off the glass. But then every so often, you'll see LeBron explode and get that board.
Rose scored as James was there waiting for him. And the contact. 8 points now for Derrick. LeBron has 12. Derrick Rose inserting himself in the game. Right at the guy who was almost his teammate with 8 points. Chalmers will press Rose, see if he fouls him. There he goes. But there's a problem. Get the bang in the bucket. That's bad. If you're going to foul him, you got the foul to give, do it out there.
Well, if you have never seen this young guy play, I mean, when he blows by you, right, you need the rotation to give your team a break. But he plays the glass, and he also has the floater if he's facing the basket. He just has a beautiful touch.
Will have taken over the world. Good defense by Bogans on Wade, and a tough shot at the end of the clock. Rose, Bosch waiting. Beat there him anyway.
Hey, there it is, shooting. And then you come with Brewer or you come with Korver. You need guys who can put the ball in the basket.
Three on two, Rose. Oh, what a finish!
Come on!
He beat Wade. James was there for the chase down. And in that one sliver of space where the ball could fit, he put it. Timeout, Miami.
That's that burst. That's that extra level that he goes through. Just watch as he explodes here. He gets the contact. How about the finish as he plays with his left hand off the glass? Beautifully, beautiful. They are going to be a handful, whoever gets them in that first round. And then the second round will be the key in the East.
Good to see Scott Wall stays in the game here. Rose rattles home the jumper. It's a three-point game. Mike Bibby's, Adrenas Ilgauskas, James Jones in for the Heat. There's that uncanny ability of Rose, not only to finish, but to go in the air and on the way down find somebody open.
Yeah, not only did he find it open, he hit the floor going to the rim and received the pass back and scores.
Oh, it's been a struggle for Bibby today.
Now just watch this. See, now he thought he was going to get fouled. Now right back to him, and then he takes the ball strong to the glass.
Most of the Bulls games I've watched this month, the lead extends with that group on the floor.
Mike, it's 15-6 in bench points. 15-6 in favor of Chicago.
Rose is back in, and he's switched on as he enters. Tirico, Hubie Brown, Heather Cox with you in Miami. Rose, what speed! Rolls it in!
How about that?
Games on every possession here.
This is just an incredible move, all right? Not only the elevation, but the broad jump and then the spin. And then right here, you could see the forearm right on the hip. Wade definitely catches him, and their energy level has been terrific.
Wade has turned it over seven times.
Yes, he has. That's a big stat in this game.
Bulls by four. Rose got another one. Timeout Miami, and Derrick Rose having an outstanding game. As Chicago tries to sweep Miami, he scored the last six.
Mike, the shot is so soft, it doesn't even look like it's going to reach the basket.
27 points for the MVP candidate, Derrick Rose, on the road in Miami. Tied at 76. And James coming across with a miss. On the other end, Derrick Rose scores, pulls up two. Then Wade looking for a foul with a lot of time left in the shot clock. A miss. Rose on the other end. Davis two free throws. And this one, the trap that Hubie talked about, the turnover. And Rose has given Miami a six-point lead the last six possessions of this game.
Now, the scoring in the second.
From Chicago, at guard, 6'3", number one, Derrick.
Wish he probably should have dunked that right there. He was so close to the rim.
Why didn't he?
And that right there, you come back on the other end, you miss a layup. Hey, to Philadelphia. He's a guy that can put up some numbers in a hurry. Gibson back to Rose. Baseline jumper. That's good. Derrick with your shooting shoes on tonight. Rose, 3-for-5. Jack loose, running hard to the baseline. Spins around, blocked by Derrick Rose.
I'll take that.
Here comes Tank.
Right now, they got 28 points in the backcourt. There's a turnover.
Steal, they run for it. And here's Rose. Oh!
Oh, my goodness.
He kind of lost the handle. Okafor the other way. That's blocked by Noah.
Good hustle by Joe.
Rose.
And Derrick Rose looks at his hands right there. He's been struggling with his shot tonight. But again, the victim was a half-court team, and they've been able to stay in the game by being able to kind of muddy the game up a little bit.
Here's Rose driving, spins a shot, scores, hand one. He changed hands in mid-flight and spun that up with his offhand with some English on it and scored. A pretty looking play.
Just an acrobatic move. Here he is. He just gets up and he just has a little space, and David West is in trouble. I mean, 9-1-1, get out the way. No way in the world he can guard him one-on-one, and he has to foul him. And then D. Rose right there shows you why he is a premier point guard in the NBA.
And it doesn't make much difference to Derrick what angle he has to attack the rim of the board. And he read that pass intended for Bellinelli, and it was not a good pass. And here is Taj, and he rips one down with two hands.
That was a nice pass by D. Rose. Kept his eyes up the whole time and found Taj Gibson for a monster dunk.
66-60. To watch the Bulls, who have been rolling, and here's part of the reason why. The break, gun down, and Taj with one hard step to the rim. Watch this.
That's a
boom,
nice.
Planted, and then dunked it with two hands. Good feed. Landry off the bench. 17 minutes. He's 4 of 8. Rose. Oh,
nice. Passed the boozer.
And that's the hang time you talked about. A lot of guys would have come down and traveled. He was able to hang up there until he spotted two Bulls with.
Here it is right there, the hang time. And again, Ronnie Brewer being guarded by
There's Rose from outside. He pours in the jumper, and you're right. He's saying, we're not going to lose to this team after a tough rebound.
And he was fading away that time.
And Rose parries one at the other end.
Well, memo to Jared Jack. Continue to go underneath the screen. Give Derrick Rose a three, and you will pay.
75-65, Bulls. Three. Right there. And suddenly,
the most improved player as well. It started in the FIBA World Championships in the summer. He knew he had to be more vocal. His game's improved in every area. I've never seen a point guard in the history of the league with the ability to finish like Derrick Rose. He can get to anywhere he wants to on the floor. You talked about the improvement, jump shooting. Nobody finishes better than Derrick Rose. And just a year ago, you talk about great point guards in the league. Was it Nash? Was it Williams? Was it Paul? Well, there's no question now. It's Derrick Rose, the only player in the NBA to rank in the top 10 in both scoring and assist. Derrick Rose, he's been sensational, and he's been the reason why the Chicago Bulls are the number one seed overall in the NBA.
He's had a terrific season since Frank Vogel took over. A lot of minutes for Tyler Hansbrough.
Got his hands full with Carlos Boozer today. They've got their hands full with Derrick Rose.
And his attitude is infectious for the rest of this ball club.
You've really got two guys in the starting five, Noah and Bogans, who don't really need the ball, allowing that guy to do that kind of stuff.
What a move. Again, we talked about him at the Open. I've really never seen a guy at the point guard position being able to finish like Derrick Rose does at the rim. The power, tremendous, as we go back to Derrick Rose. And how about avoiding the charge, switches to the left hand. I remember a guy that wore number 23 that used to do that a little bit here. I don't know. There's a statue
out front. There. You put it out there. Late in the season, as did a number of the young players under Frank Vogel. Collison slips inside. What a recovery by Rose.
What a recovery.
Spins inside. Hello.
Oh, my.
This block. Collison beats him. Derrick Rose doesn't give up on the play, gets up and gets it just before it hits the glass. It's legitimate. And on the other end, how about the spin?
Which way did he go, said Tyler Hansbrough, and a great finish with the English.
Just the best efforts and already some ooh and ah kind of plays from Derrick Rose.
Well, the inexperience factor, phooey. This guy's come out, the runner to start it, the ability to get to the lane. How about the defense? Collison beats him. He doesn't give up on the play. And the beautiful spin move. Another easy basket in the paint for him.
The first quarter. 3 second difference, game clock and shot clock. Rose, high off the glass and
good.
That's
too easy. Dan, that's just too easy. The whole team knew they were going isolation. Oh, what a look. Oh, what a look.
Everybody in the building thought Noah was getting the ball.
What a look. Oh, wow. And here's Rose, jumps in the air. Just the look off. Tyler Hansbrough goes over to Noah. Bad mistake. You don't need to run out to Noah outside the paint.
Regular season rotations that have been good today. Rose draws another foul.
And he didn't like it. He didn't like it. That's a playoff foul. Maybe this is going to be the thing that gets this Chicago Bulls team going. Derrick Rose has played well.
Hibbert talked about saying hello to Derrick Rose at the rim. And Jeff Foster first got him with the body, then came down hard with the arms.
You're exactly right, Dan. It was the second hit.
Granger runs into Thomas, forces a turnover.
Forget
it.
How about the extra gear? No chance. Again, another finish by D. Rose, and the Bulls fighting back. Down just four here in the second. For Frank Vogel to be a confident guy. As I said, a young group. If they can sense that he's not confident, as Porter knocks down a long three, he'll eventually be the youngest MVP in the history of the game. But Darren Collison's been terrific too. Rose started out early. Everything he's done has been to the paint. The ability to get in there, absolutely sensational. And on the defensive end, he's done it as well. Getting into the lane, the spins, the English on the glass. How about the Jets here at half court? Until Josh McRoberts threw up a three at the buzzer. You gotta just eat it.
Eat it.
Eat it.
Rose left hand. Yes.
Oh my goodness. This guy.
Lando.
Wonder where Tyler Hansbrough's brother is going to get drafted, Dan.
What he had.
Had a heck of a year.
Unbelievable
year. Oh, there's a jumper.
Derrick Rose, 24.
And they're giving up wide open shots.
Nearly stolen. Now Rose does have it. Another block by Rose. And a shot clock violation. Down the stretch. Off the rim. Loose ball to Chicago.
One of the easier opportunities he's had. He's not able to get it. What a break!
Derrick Rose finds Joakim Noah with a bullet of a pass. Noah finishes, draws the foul. The building is alive. The Bulls are within four. 2:27 to go. Rose.
Oh, no! How does he do it, Dan? Oh, my goodness.
He makes moves that you have to see them in slow motion to really understand what he just did.
Oh, the ball, he spun it in from underneath the hook. Look at, there's no room there. He avoids the charge. Puts a little overspin on the ball, hits the front of the rim, and gets the and one if he makes the free throw. I'll tell you what, there's no plays that I need to call for the Chicago Bulls. It's Derrick Rose at the top, and everybody else get out of the way, because he is an unstoppable force of getting into the paint.
Rose again, spinning, floater, yes! The Chicago Bulls have not led for a single second in this game. Carver! The lead. Derrick Rose with a couple of baskets, and then with all the attention on him, he finds Carver for the three.
57 threes made in the fourth quarter for Kyle Korver this season, the most in the NBA. It's all about Derrick Rose. He gets the attention, wide open Korver. That's why he's on the floor. What a shot and what a comeback for the Chicago Bulls. How about the spin move, the floater up over Paul George, nothing but the bottom. And the Bulls just down 10, 2.5 minutes ago, have taken the lead.
They're on a 14-1 run right now for their first lead of the game. Frank Vogel.
I mean, last year you talked about great point guards, Williams, Nash, Paul, maybe throwing Westbrook and Rondo, and then you say, maybe Derrick Rose too. There's no doubt who the best point guard in the NBA is right now.
No,
it's Derrick Rose, and maybe the best player in basketball.
The likely MVP for the regular season has opened up the postseason with one heck of a statement here today. 39 points.
Has missed, you know, over 34 games. So you got to understand, this team has great depth.
And a guy that's never been a head coach prior to this year, Tom Thibodeau, spent over two decades as an assistant and could be the coach of the year in the NBA. The job he's done, Chicago, won 41 games each of the last 2 years as Derrick Rose gets his first basket of the game.
Now, early in his career, that would be a difficult move. In differential, the number one in field goal shooting percentage against and number one in three-point shooting against. Now, that guy, you've got to guard him.
You know, in the year, he had 32 in his first 2 years combined. A steal. Here's Rose in the open floor. What a move by Derrick Rose. He scored the last seven for Chicago.
This is where, now this is off the transition. See, he came off the screen. You switch. Now, once you switch out and you have a big guy on him, hey, it's going to be all over, because he'll give you hesitation. You lay off, he'll shoot. And then in the open floor,
there's gave it away. And now here's Rose in transition. The blow by and the finish with the left. Wow.
Now, look, there's only one other guy in this league, in my opinion, that gets there from circle to circle as quick as him, and that's LeBron James. This is all about speed. Just watch how he blows by people. He handles so well. He finishes either with his right or his left. Watch the forearm go out. Now, also the cradle in case he was hit.
Another 50-win season for Orlando. Four straight. That is a franchise record as Rose again gets to the bucket and banks it in. And he's got 11 points, 5 of 5 shooting.
Yeah, I like what you said. That's the second one in this quarter.
Rose again beautifully to the goal. Wow. Derrick Rose with 15 in the first quarter.
Now, let me tell you, that was some change of direction, okay?
A 10-1 magic run to get back within two. Rose taking it to the goal. Finishing with the left. What a move by Derrick Rose.
Now that was cagey. All right, that was just beautiful. I mean, Derrick Rose on his baseline dribble and how he shifts hands right there. That is just a clever finish.
It's hurting us right now.
All right, thank you. Dave.
15 first quarter points for Rose, 17 for the half, and Chicago on the road has a one-point lead. T-Mobile halftime report up next, as we'll have first half analysis for you and a preview of the Celtics and Heat in that battle for the two seed in the East. Chicago, the number one seed in the East, still a chance at the number one over.
Well, the main thing is a better shot attempt, okay? You say, well, it's only better because, you know, he missed the shot. No, because you had plenty of time on the clock.
Derrick Rose with 31 points.
The reason why Orlando's in the game, they've made 10 threes in this game and the 11 points on second chance points. This guy has just been great. That's his second three.
Going to about his rebounding, he has 7 boards today. Rose got it blocked by Bass. Got it back. Oh, man. 33 for MVP Derrick Rose.
How about the angle? Come on now. He was a shade behind the rim. The fact that defense Korver.
Got 7 turnovers in the quarter, but Richardson just throws it away. Now Rose on the other end throws it down.
Now that's a break. That's it. Just give them. Watch right here. Now you're going to see the. I leave my feet. I throw it out. Rose is going to finish and finish strong. Both hands.
Here is Rose inside. Changes hands. Can go either way with either hand.
Here we see right here on the previous possession. You see the screen right here, the set on the right, but he doesn't go over the screen. He goes to the left. He loves going away. Pump fakes, Akeem Olajuwon, then he switches to the left hand. This guy is great when he gets it down.
Indiana in the game, they shot 56% from three-point range in game one. Boozer down low for first. How about these credentials? Allen Iverson's speed. He has the vision of Jason Kidd. Shooting ability for a point guard of Chauncey Billups. And he says he has the athleticism of Michael Jordan. And so game one, Derrick Rose exhibited all of that. But with under 7.5 to go in the first half. Here is Rose trying to get his team back in the game, and what better way?
One way they're defending Derrick Rose is by going at him on the other end, trying to wear him down, show him different looks.
Here is Dang for three. He's got it. Luol Deng. Getting back in, they were down by 8.
They were down by 8 till this guy came back in. That's Derrick Rose. He finds his three-point shooter, Luol Deng, one of the most consistent players of the season this year. Then he says, wait a minute, guys. Let me do what I do best. Take that.
Scoring for the fourth consecutive year. Indiana by 4, nearly 5 to go. Here, spinning his way in is Rose, and he lays it in.
Rose is a great coach, but still with that situation, no Yao Ming, I'm surprised you can get rid of your one constant.
Rose tips the pass away and lays it in. Chicago ball.
Here you have it right here. Not only can he just block shots up high, he keeps his hand in the passing lane. Coaches love to keep a statistic talking about deflections. Their coaches are happy because he got a deflection and the steal on that play. For Indiana right now, they need
Boozer,
their lead.
Not so much by Hansbrough. Rose for three and still goes empty. And the offensive rebound, Rose lays it in. Good pass from Boozer to Rose. Who, by the way, now 0 for 12 and 3.
Well, great done, great by Bogans. He's had a little guy, A.J. Price, on him. He waited for a streaky Rose to come down.
Looking to regain the lead, and you will hear this crowd explode if they do. Here is Rose for three. Three fouls on Noah now.
And we're back to the Rose show. He comes up, squares his feet. The big fella steps out. No one comes up. Rose says, I know I'm 1 for 11, but hold on. I'm going to get on track. This is why I shoot all those jumpers in the summer.
said, we're ready. Do us whatever you want to do to us because we're playing hard tonight. I love seeing that intensity by point guards.
Bogans hitting the three. First points of the game for Keith Bogans. Timeout. Now you hear the crowd.
There we go. If you want to make a 19-5 run, you get it to your best player. And what does he do? He shares the ball. He shows he's the most valuable player because he can find people on his team. He knows his personnel. Derrick Rose.
Rose sparking the third quarter drive.
That's right. Derrick Rose is the catalyst for this team. The smallest guy on the court, but it has the biggest heart. Attacking inside, he says, wait, I know you don't think I can shoot threes. Let me hit you with this. And then there's his greatest asset, trusting his teammates. Great job by Derrick Rose in the second half.
Bogans hit a three earlier. Leaves it for Rose. Look how quick he gets it. Derrick Rose. 20 points for Rose. Earlier this year, he had 42.
Right there, but right here on the other end, it happened. Hesitation coming off the pick. He goes up. Hibbert can't get him. No one on the other side to help. Stop that man, Mighty Mouse, from going to the hole.
Foul was looking inside for Boozer. And Rose leaves it for Thomas outside. Hits the two. Kurt Thomas with the basket. Going to use a lot of what Doug Collins employed, and we're seeing it here. Here's a three-point attempt. No defense there. And he finally breaks the three-point drought.
Derrick Rose. Right here, you see the switching. Kyle Korver turns it to the point guard. Gets it to the point guard, who turns it to the three-point shooter. Feet square.
They had to bring Psycho T back in there to negate the physicality of the Bulls.
Here's Rose working against Granger. Fires it up. Hits! Basket counts and a foul!
Are you kidding me?
Closest thing to a smile we've seen on the face of Derrick Rose, I think, in this series.
Exactly. Probably closest we'll see all year, even when he gets that trophy. Crossover, goes inside. Hibbert's a seven-footer, you guys. Hibbert came over here. Here you go. He crosses over Granger, comes over. Hibbert comes for help. He gets the foul and one, and a deservedly chant from the hometown fans.
Granger with his 34 minutes remaining in the fourth. Rose pulls back, hits another. Timeout, Indiana.
Big man, you gotta love that. Look at this, now it's Rose's turn. Step back, herky-jerky, a little bit of Tim Hardaway, take that.
The Bulls have scored 7 straight points, just under 4 minutes remaining. They're up by 5.
Right here, Rose comes off the pick and roll, frees it right there. In the first half and even in the third quarter, they trapped that and got some turnovers by Rose. They elect to switch now. Does this look familiar? Is this Chris Paul on Paul Gasol? Well, that's what it feels like to any big man checking a little guy. Believe me, I can tell you that from the
Bulls with the ball leading by 2 as we approach 2 minutes to go in the fourth. Rose with the lay-in. 34 now for Rose, who had 30.
Limited tickets available for game 4 on Saturday afternoon, but the Pacers in this crowd only playoffs for a 19th time. The Bulls in the NBA playoffs for a 30th time as Rose hits the three.
Boy, there was only 3 seconds on the shot clock. Pacers got
a 12-3 Indiana run. Rose, pull-up jump shot, challenged by George, but Rose gets his second field goal of the night. Thomas in for the first time tonight.
If you go to double team and it gets rid of him, you can't let him get it back.
Here's a three-point shot by Rose. Derrick Rose hits his second of the night. In the first 2 games, he was 2 of 14. Rose shot fake inside and hands roll, knocked to the floor, no foul, no other rebound. Noah goes inside and scores. Joakim Noah has 6, his first second quarter field goal, and it's a 1-point Pacers lead at 40-39. Thomas catches.
You can't go for a steal. Jeff Foster.
And then Rose gets in the face of Jeff Foster. That was a hard foul from Foster. And I'm surprised that the officials let Rose say something to Jeff Foster.
No, I'm not. Not when he was about to take off and he got smashed. Now, if they call a double technical, I wouldn't be surprised.
Well, it's a timeout with 5:59 to play. They will.
Because you can take a look and see Jeff gets into him. And then he stays with him. See, he stays into him when it looks like Rose is going away.
Tyler Hansbrough had a piece of that too. Rose at the free throw line when we come back.
Little action inside.
9 to play, third quarter. Boozer made the steal. They tried to force it to Hansbrough. Corver's three, good.
Come on, they got to call it.
Game clock, about a 16-second difference. Dante Jones is in now to guard Derrick Rose as Paul George is guarding Kyle Korver.
And a good job guarding him. The shot clock is down.
It's down to 7 now.
See, nope. They ran a screen and roll with Hibbert because they knew it was going to be difficult for him to guard him. Oh, my goodness. Oh, when he hit his head after he made the shot, the Pacers going to take a timeout.
He got to the basket. Derrick Rose to give the Bulls a 2-point lead.
I mean, he made a tough, tough basketball play. This is why they're talking about him for the MVP. They tried to run a high screen and roll, and they ran it with Hibbert because you remember when they run it with the power forwards, the Pacers have trapped. So Hibbert is there, and then George lets him get through. Granger doesn't get there in time, and you see he's able to get himself to the rim and still get it off the glass with touch. With the left hand. Now he goes down. And he goes down kind of hard. He popped his head, but I thought the Pacers had a good chance to close him out. You got to come close the guy out. You can't let him get to the lane. You make him pass the ball to jump shooters.
And now 17 and 8, 10 seconds to play. Derrick Rose, 23 points tonight. Just 4 of 18 from the field, but he's a closer and delivers the big shot. So many times this year, the regular season, the Bulls notes document 22 times he helped the Bulls win games in the fourth quarter.
Derrick says there's still a little soreness, but he says he's ready to go.
Well, having a couple of days between games, I think.
Got a 4. Rose fires for 3. Gathered in by Noah. So Noah finding Rose on the right baseline.
And right away at one end with the offensive board, the assist. And there's Rose getting his first hoop in the paint. And then at the other end, his first attempt.
Here is Rose, saw the opening, takes all the way. Derrick Rose able to slip through the Bulls with a 12-2 advantage. And the Pacers will talk it over.
Well, this is the Bulls team that won 62 games in the regular season. Defense and transition and relying heavily on the probable MVP of the league.
Pacers 12-2.
Shoots the 3 well, just under 40%. As Rose saw the opening. That's too easy. It comes out of the foul. Derrick Rose moving well on that, on that ankle.
Paul said, I mean, the Red Sea parts here. Watch the crossover on George, who was anticipating a pick, and then he's so fast that he beats all 3 Pacer defenders who try to rotate. And that's why he is who he is, that explosive combo of getting these guys to understand the offense. He's simplified things. He's really cut down on the playbook as Hogan's knocks down another 3 from the corner. But Frank Vogel gave this Pacer team a more defined identity of youth and energy here.
Pacers appear to be in good shape, but potentially have 35 to 40 million in contracts. How about Rose? 9 points here at the start. Playoff coverage. Coming up on 4 minutes remaining in this first quarter. Bulls getting off to the quick start, now lead it by 7. Dang! For 3. The Bulls have hit 3 of 4 from beyond the 3-point line. Looks like a technical foul has been called. It is on Joakim Noah
here. He's saying he was elbowed right here by Foster. And a push there. And it's always the retaliation that is seen, never the first one.
Rose pulls it up. Derrick Rose, red hot here at the start. He is 5 for 7, 11 points.
Well, his shooting percentage has really suffered in this series, particularly the last couple of games. So for Bulls fans,
he says he's 6'9", although he's listed at 6'8". His length has given some problems to Rose the last couple of games. Gibson. Taj Gibson with a wide open look.
He made a defensive adjustment after the first couple of games of the series, trying to put
more length on Derrick as he comes up with a block. But between George and Dante Jones, they're trying to put size on Derrick Rose. Didn't shoot that well from the perimeter for that club. Most of the European teams played off of him. So it was something he really worked on all summer long, and it sure has paid off.
How about Bogans with his third three-pointer? He is 3 for 3 from downtown.
And I talked about it in the first half.
Tom Thibodeau taking a chance with lots of time remaining. 6 minutes to go in the third quarter. Here is Gibson off a pick.
Yes.
Gibson with his second field goal. The Bulls now made it 6 to 3
with foul trouble. And you're giving up the lead. I mean, that's just as bad as picking up another one, because either way, he's not on the floor.
Rose hitting the three. By 9. Mansbro gets it down low. Hibbert. Oh! He kept it!
The official to make. And then here was the block. Watch Rose come from the weak side. Incredible. He's a point guard.
Rose played by George. See Hibbert switch it off. Rose, yes! He's hit consecutive threes. Indiana will take a timeout. So Derrick Rose, playing despite the 4 fouls, comes on, hits 2 straight from downtown, and since that timeout, the Bulls with 8 unanswered points.
Now this is why you take the risk. If you're Tom Thibodeau, he's the MVP of the league. You gotta have him on the floor. The three, the block shot, another three, in Chicago back up by 12.
Dang, with a rather rough shot from Dang with a deep three. Timeout taken by the Pacers.
Well, take a look at the block from Chicago. First Noah, another one from Gibson. The length and athleticism on this front line, just remarkable. And Derrick Rose with his third straight three-pointer.
As we call, just a jump ball. The officials did talk it over. Rose picked off and deflected back to Rose. Bogans for 3.
Yes.
4 three-pointers for Keith Bogans.
Atlanta does have is a number of athletic one-on-one players that are capable of making shots.
Here's Rose. 7-point lead. And Brewer in the game lays it in. Ronnie Brewer, who's been bothered by a sprained left thumb.
Defense of the Hawks. That's when the leader with the ball makes good decisions. He's got his head up. He knows where to go. Drive right. Here comes his teammate off his hip.
Hands of Korver. Here is Rose. Rose finally gets on the scoreboard with under 5 minutes to go in the first half.
Watch him turn it on here. 1 defender, 2 defenders. There's the third one, the fourth one waiting at the rim, Joe Johnson.
7-point lead. The big thing he wanted to cut down, the turnovers from round one.
Yeah, go back to when they lost 83-80 to Atlanta. 17 turnovers. We see Rose hit the three-pointer. But 17 turnovers in that game for Chicago, which led way up.
Nosebleed section. Here's Korver with a quick three, and he's got it. And this is the closest the Bulls have been to the first half. 3-point game. Rose feeding Boozer, gets the basket. Semifinals, including the last 2 years, and 15 straight games. Noah misses the lay-in. Here's Rose inside. That drops. Derrick Rose now with 7 points on 3-for-11 shooting.
You want to know why? Rose penetrates, almost stripped there, but Noah happens to save it. He gets it up there, and then who winds up coming up with the ball? The original guy, Derrick Rose, that tried to penetrate.
Bulls close well, don't they?
Yeah, and that's a tough guy to shoot it over. You see Rose in penetration, transition opportunity. Larry Drew may take a quick timeout. Get him out in the open floor. Let him attack the defense while they're trying to get back. He's so tough to stop. Size, speed, quickness, strength.
Johnson's hands. And Derrick Rose spinning his way in. And the Derrick Rose show may just be beginning.
Rose, the strip that time. Watch this reverse, pull back, split the defenders, conversion by Derrick Rose.
And Jeff Teague shouldn't feel bad about that. He's done that against everybody.
Like Chicago has, is in their own building, and they're down at the half. You know they're coming back.
Derrick Rose working his way in, lofts it, and it drops. Derrick Rose now with 13. But this is the thought, maybe the matchup would be better against this Atlanta team. Here's Rose trying to get his team back in. That's the way to do it with a field goal, and Rose now with 15.
Well, we caught it, got it up there with 1 second left.
Watson misses, ball batted out to Rose. Passes up the three, wins his way in, gets the tough lay-in. Rose now with 17.
Is there anyone that...
Korver trying to get free. Teague doing a good job defensively on him. Rose, Noah. Noah with the lay-in.
Derrick Rose, the ability to go behind the backboard, up in the air. Three red jerseys, he finds his teammate, Joaquino.
If he can. 8-point lead, Rose has it. And Derrick Rose puts it through.
A little move coming out of the timeout by Tom Thibodeau.
The Bulls here in the fourth.
Look, denying, not letting them have it back, and then anticipating from the weak side, Derrick Rose gets the steal and finishes. He's had it on him.
Rose
done a very good job.
And plenty of time left. Here's Rose for three, and that's why there's plenty of time left, as Derrick Rose.
You second guess yourself 100 times.
Rose, 2-point basket. Fratello, David Aldridge, and the rest of the crew, I'm Dick Stockton saying goodbye from Chicago. And coming up, you'll have an update.
He's going to say it's just fine, but he continues to receive all-day treatment on it. Ice stim, different medications. He told me there's still some swelling, but not really much pain.
It's a tough shot and misses, and Larry Drew is frustrated with shot selection in game two. Rose all the way home for the Bulls.
On the play right into the Chicago game plan. Easy baskets on the break, and in second shot attempt.
Early timeout. 49 seconds in. Bring it back on that basket. Carlos Boozer rolling and scores with the left hand. Boozer is the picture of confidence as he goes back and guards Derrick Rose. Rose let him recover and drive by. And the MVP's off to a good start as well. And his opportunity is getting it here against the MVP of the league and holding his own. But that guy still has the upper hand. 9 for Rose to start.
Right. Now, with Crawford in the game, Joe Johnson's at small forward.
Yep.
He and Deng will match up.
Rose, a floater!
Oh!
It was so high and soft, he was there to catch it when it came out of the goal.
Hey, get those pigeons, will you? Get all those dead pigeons. I mean, we're talking. That was really high in the air.
Has led the Hawks here, beat with 10 assists in the first two games.
Nice.
Rose and Boozer, a little screen and roll. To perfection. So inside, the foul on the Bulls.
Now this Rose, this is just a beautiful release.
Johnson, no airspace. Teague, that time denied by Rose.
Good defense that time by Noah. He was up challenging that shot. Look at this.
And Noah set the great screen, Hubie, to send Rose home.
An excellent rebounder and a solid shot blocker. Big thing for him now is just make him shoot over the top. Oh.
Did you see the move by the MVP? What a play by Rose.
Now, if you doubt his quickness or you doubt his ball-handling ability, you just saw it right there.
They had 5 of 6 for 11, but excuse me.
Just watch this guy as he steps in. You know, see how he cradles the ball? He protects the ball in case he gets bumped. But not only is this explosion, the strength. How about that crossover? And then I'm going down inside. And I don't think he's worried about that ankle tonight. And he loves the bang.
Rose used the screen from Ashiq. And Derrick Rose has a 17-point first quarter. That's a big question for the Hawks after last year. Were they going to bring this group of young players back intact? And they did. What a release by Rose. Over the shot blocking Smith.
Mike, he's really a great shooter, and it's a catch and shoot.
Derrick Rose again. Largest lead of the series for the Bulls, and they have for one seed in the NBA. They've scored 8 in a row, and Derrick Rose is 21. series even at one, and Chicago making a first half statement here in game three.
Because he'll get a high percentage shot in the lane.
Rose showing no bandaging on that hand that he hurt earlier. Proves he is absolutely fine. Knocks down a three. And the Bulls trying to get home court back after the Hawks won game one at the United Center. Bogans getting knocked out of bounds, knocks down a three. And what a three-point shooting show for Chicago. 26-15, Bulls a very good road team this year. Backing up their great home record of 36-5, all led by that guy, Derrick Rose.
Now he got plenty of time here once you get it in.
Noah, the cutting Rose, finishes over Smith, 29 for Derrick.
Now that move. Now just watch this here, great backdoor move. See, they caught Teague looking for where the basketball was. If you're going to look, you better have a forearm on your offensive man. So that if he...
There it is.
I'm telling you.
Everything. Yeah.
We have a lot of players in this league. Now, this is just a very difficult shot. Now, you can see Teague is right there. Look at that. Look at the release. But he plays the glass. It's the old story. If the angle, when you learn how
to... As many as 19. They have not led. Rose has 36 here tonight. Rose has 38 here tonight.
His patience. They ran a screen two times for Korver. Now, Derrick has already looked on the left side over there twice for Korver. And this is just a great shot. No way. Jeff Teague cannot play him any better than that.
Set up again. For a career playoff high, 41 points for the MVP, Derrick Rose. The NBA this year, the Bulls.
Now that's a second turnover there for Teague. This is just Derrick at his best. No hesitation. You lay off him tonight. Just think about it. Only 17 points between them. But more important, Mike, bad looks, Mike. They're not getting good looks.
Derrick Rose, most points he's had in his NBA career, 44 for Rose. All of you who said, boy, is he really the MVP?
Oh,
is this guy the best player in the league? Can we have you out there, folks? Derrick Rose, highest scoring total of his career in a one-all playoff series on the road. But 44 is not too shabby.
Mike, he's showing us the full package. There he goes. That's one of his four threes. Here on the drive, he's just been excellent, whether right or left. Backdoor Teague in that situation. Now watch how he plays the glass. That high release off balance. Now this is just, hey, I have nothing at the...
Teague has played well in the absence of the injured Kirk Heinrich. Derrick Rose with a career-high 44 on Friday night, 16 of 27 from the field, including four three-pointers. Heard the chat of MVP here in Atlanta for this year.
So it's a club that has been low on energy, and there are just times when they really struggle.
Shot clock running down, and Rose able to bail out the ball.
And that's what he does. He's probably the best shooter in the world at that floater. Jim. And this is what makes Derrick Rose so tough to cover. When he can't get to the paint, he just rises up. 29th in the league in paint points, about 36 per game. So Chicago has not played its style defense yet to this point.
Dang knocks down a three. Luau Dang off to the good start.
Coast to coast off the rebound, showing you his talent.
Here is Rose. Rose with the tip. Crowd wanted offensive interference.
And the crowd's in it. Hawks are playing with tremendous energy.
Here comes Rose. And you just saw the speed of Derrick Rose because the Hawks were back. That's an 8-1 run by Chicago. Rose over Teague, yes. All right, here comes Rose. Teague backpedaling. Rose able to split through, lost the handle. Recovered by Noah. Rose on the runner.
But it was nowhere to go for him in transition, and he kind of forced it up.
Atlanta by eight. Bogans for three, yes. Got like 4 minutes remaining in this third quarter. Rose backing it up on Smith, gets the snap and scores. Man. What a move by Derrick Rose. Johnson got picked off, then able to recover. Nice pass. Ashik, who was wide open. And Rose.
Foul again.
Well, take a look at the read here. He jumps. He waits for the defense to respond, and then he finds Ashik with the perfect feed for 3 or 4 minutes. But Rose is still on the floor. No sign of Watson. You know, will Thibodeau keep him out here the rest of the game?
Rose with the runner.
He makes shots like that, he probably will be out here for a while, but it's been a struggle.
71, game four, this best of seven. Pulls up 2 games to 1. Another runner by Rose. It counts, and the foul.
Maybe the best running jump shooter in the NBA, that floater. It's such a touch, a feel shot. Tony Parker, the other guy who comes to mind. Mark Jackson was always so good with this shot, but that's really kind of Rose. The most effective is right around the hoop.
They double up on Rose. Rose, going glass, loves that shot. Able to move to his right and bank it home.
He was six
called on Brewer.
And here's Rose's third consecutive hoop to start this quarter. And once he gets his head and shoulders by the defender. Back in Atlanta where the Bulls have a 1-point lead, and while it hasn't been the spectacular game that Derrick Rose had in game three, he is picking it up big time. You see 28 points, many of which coming on these floating shots going to the rim. And you see the type of problems he poses for defenses, Marv, guarding each other at both ends. And it's not a matchup you'd normally see either guy with. It's Rose! Gets the floater and the foul.
So Rose to the line.
And here's that pick. Really strong pick from Noah. And then Rose, just a little hesitation move. Makes Smith commit and then respond to the roll game. But, you know, high pick and roll with Teague and Korver guarding him may free him up.
Rose. Another strong move by Derrick Rose. Again, the final score, the Atlanta Hawks 100, the Chicago Bulls 88. For Steve Kerr, David, in game four, he said he had good looks, missed too many layups. Head coach Tom Thibodeau telling us, well, he doesn't take issue with the volume of shots that he saw the other night.
I had no
problem. Run Bogans with the steal. Dang with Rose. Yes.
He had a foot on the line. With Josh Smith and Al Horford as well can come over and help.
Rose for three. So Chicago off to the sparkling start.
When Rose makes threes, he's impossible to guard. He knocks down his first one here tonight. That may be a bad omen for the Atlanta Hawks. Boston, as Horford drops an easy layup. Chicago and Boston do it more than any team in the league.
Oh, nice play. They're pushing the ball so effectively. Rose, the finisher.
First 3-4 games. The fourth game, he did well for him.
Good luck from Rose to find Boozer. Here comes Rose. Puts Boozer on Johnson. Gets by him and scores! Derrick Rose, so elusive. Noah sets the screen. Rose accelerates. And we're seeing a different Derrick Rose here. Rose met by Johnson. Bogans for three. Yes. Keith Bogans able to keep the opposition honest. He'll hit it.
Joe Johnson and Crawford have to make shots because when they don't, long rebounds lead to this. Transition for the best transition player in the NBA. Derrick Rose taking it to the Hawks.
Atlanta outscored Chicago 9-4 in those moments. Boozer right back with the stuff.
He's feeling pretty good about his game. And here's that play, the pick and roll. Beautiful feed from Derrick Rose. To clean things up quickly to get their man back out on the floor.
Horford is to check back in. Oh, he had no angle. Derrick Rose somehow able to find the space.
And I like what the Bulls have done tonight.
In this first half, Bulls have led by as many as 15. It's up to 10. Derrick Rose off to the good start, 11 points, 5 assists. We'll be back to the United Center in a moment.
Seconds and Horford lost his rhythm.
Rose with the step. Rose to the pocket.
Rose waiting. When those bigs get caught in the lane, well, that's when you see that call.
Rose pulls it back. Beautiful move.
Yes! And the foul!
He was able to separate himself from T, but T kept coming.
That is called. Remember, he made that three-pointer early on, and look at that move through the legs, and then gets the bump from T. Crowd in.
Nice move by Rose, taking to the rim. Put the speed on and beat T off the dribble.
That's the thing to come back. I mean, a lot of people thought they were really quitting in certain games. And this team has shown a ton of resilience.
Oh, nice pass. Rose for Dang. The Bulls
got
now
pushed on that drive, but this is the one before. Look at the cut from Dang. He sees that the defense is occupied. Four people right around Derrick Rose.
Rose on the move. Teague is back. Rose for Gibson. Yes! And it counts.
It's going to be with their defense because their best offense is their defense. The transition hoop from Rose to Gibson. The bench loves it. This is a team.
Rose ducking it on the team and score. Went right at Josh Smith.
Well, Marv, under pressure, you go to what you're comfortable.
Just confuse the defense a little bit, you might get open.
Here's Rose around Horford. It counts and the foul.
After what? I think the Hawks may be a little tired. Teague gets screened, and Horford tries to help. But this deep into the fourth quarter, if you're Horford, you've been doing this for the entire game. Your legs
are still alive. It's down to 7. Rose with the runner. Huh?
But no call, and as a result, Bulls retain possession, and he scores.
So Chicago has to take care of the ball. They better get it together quickly here.
Rose knocks it down. As for the season series, for what it's worth, and things very different.
They're going to have to respond to penetration, which will allow for offensive rebounding opportunities.
Rose, the three-pointer.
Well, if you're Eric Spoelstra,
off the bench coming on for Bibby.
Yeah, it's almost like Bibby's had dead legs as Rose gets into the paint for another score. And that's how he's going to be sixth of the series, a +9 versus the Celtics. This is a team that shoots 30 times as Derrick Rose gets another outside shot to go.
That's something. Defensive player rolling to the hoop.
Miami has a 2-point lead. Rose, yes. So the game is tied at 46.
Derrick Rose has played a spectacular
percent. They hit 19 of 40. Shot clock at 7. Rose for 3. That's his second 3-pointer.
And we started the game with Derrick Rose knocking down.
He set his feet. Not able to hit from 3-point territory. Now Rose sets it up for 3. Yes. That is his third from downtown.
Just gets a little hand on the ball. It rolls back. Rose with an
after the block. Rose with the runner. Yes. Rose, yes. 26 points.
And you got to guard the MVP and Derrick Rose, who has been, as Marv would say,
players getting involved. Bogans, CJ Watson, Derrick Rose. He's
throughout the game and hearing it from this crowd. Here's Rose with a runner.
Wow.
I feel pretty good about things. I mean, you haven't made a shot and yet you're right in the game here. Rose gets all the way to the rim. It's a tie game. Chicago's 5-for-19 from the field. Second quarter.
Rose only 1-of-6 from the field. Bulls with a 34.
And the team went to a zone. You know, to kind of just throw off the speed of the Sixers.
Rose got the step. Going right at Haslam.
I think he's the best basketball player in the NBA right now.
Well, it's hard for me to turn down Kobe Bryant or LeBron James, but offensively, there's no one as skilled as Dirk.
11 for Chicago. Rose over Bibby.
Yeah, Amir Spoelstra.
With their performance, keeping the Chicago crowd out of it, Derrick Rose finally knocks one down. He's just
in little spurts.
9 points, 4 rebounds for Haslam. That counts and the foul.
And it'll be a sheet going to the free throw line for one.
The fact that Haslam's going to play short bursts, as you see the foul there from Bibby and the jump shot from Rose. But the question now is,
here comes Rose. Rose able to split through and scores.
That's their best offense.
So the Bulls in possession. Halfway through this first quarter, here's Rose on the run. Oh, Derrick Rose going right at Chris Bosh.
How about the pick from Omer Sheik?
Already 0-1 with no points here in 6 minutes.
Rose, yes. Rose has got three of them. Rose passed on a three. Here's Rose leading. It counts and the foul.
Talk about putting pressure on the inch screen and just throws the ball right back to Rose. Just a step too late is LeBron James.
And this is why Korver's in.
Here's Rose on the run. Rose splits through and scores. Beautiful move by Derrick Rose.
Just had a wide open layup, and here's Derrick Rose. Talk about in the open court. There's three white jerseys around him, and he's just able to finish over the top of Chris Bosh.
But very similar to games one and two. You know, close game at halftime, and Rose rises up and knocks down the three. And now we are tied. So which team's going to make the run in game one? Bogans has done a terrific job. Brewer as well on keeping Wade out of the paint tonight.
Oh, Rose with a spectacular move. Derrick Rose cutting right and then left and hitting the jumper.
That's pure.
Here's the bucket from Rose, as you mentioned. Reggie going off that right foot, fading away.
Bang in possession. Here's the lead out. Here comes Rose. Bosses back. Rose. Oh, got the roll.
How far out did he take off on that? I didn't know what he was doing.
Well, that one dribble. He had one of these 75, 76 type games because of both defenses.
Well, Rose able to knock down the outside shot. Has not shot well in
to go against Chris Bosh.
Mark, how friendly are they? What a second. Here is Rose all the way. Derrick Rose putting the
and we talked about how is the Bulls going to score. To me, it's got to be offensive rebounds, and they've got to pick up the pace here in transition. Derrick Rose.
Rebounded by Boozer.
Got Korver on the wing.
Here's Rose all the way. And the foul.
Or a dunk if you want one, Derrick.
Did you see how fast? As soon as Rose got the basketball, it's almost like he hit a jet, and then the explosion to the rim. Chalmers tries to slow him down here, going for the basketball. That's a terrible foul for Mario Chalmers, but look at the explosion.
44% from the field, 17 for 39. What a move by Rose.
Oh!
Yes, and it counts over Joel Anthony.
Dude, I don't blame you, Reg, because this was as spectacular a move as you will ever see. That guy's 6'2", Joel Anthony 6'11". That's, but here the Bulls are. One win away from taking back home court advantage, and you got the.
How'd you find an opening, and how'd you get that high?
I'm just trying to get myself going. Missing shots, that's part of the game.
You missed that little layup. Well, when there's pace in the game like this, Charles and I were talking. When you get some pace in the game, there's seams for him to get into. He's unbelievable.
Under things we talked about, this looks like night and day compared to the first three games. But even if you go back to game one, the Bulls won, they got off to a slow start. But they are playing at a much better.
Kerr, Reggie Miller, Craig Sager from Miami. Rose, yes.
Talk about that act summary and everything that jumped out to me. How about those points in the
top? Nice move by Rose to get inside and score.
Oh, man.
This kid is unbelievable. 14 turnovers for 16 points. This is a team that only averages about 13 turnovers a game.
Rose knocks down a three. And Miami can for the Adi Zero crazy light play of the game.
Well, we need the two principals and the owners of the last three most valuable players, Derrick Rose and LeBron.
Up short, And Dang with the outlet to Rose, chased down by Bosch. Rose lays it home, and Bosch playing with five fouls, did not want. Dang with the open shot. Noah tried to keep it alive. He does, and Rose is right there.
Well, it's interesting. Noah only had one offensive rebound in game three. Came
pretty much shooting either direction, I think. Rose with the flip off the rebound.
Did you have a way that you would...
Rose picking his way and scores. He was able to slip through.
Well, the crowd is back into it.
And then it's Derrick Rose in transition, finding the easy two. And if I'm Luol Deng's,
Bang rebounds. So Miami have a bit of a drought after their good run. Here's Rose pulling it up. Yes. Chalmers. Chalmers blocked by Rose. And he is fouled.
For the Chicago Bulls defensively. Rose comes up with the block. Dang with the rebound. This is what you're going to have to do.
But he controlled the pace of the game. The pace that Chicago wanted, he was at. He was in his groove. He was not turning the ball over recklessly. He wasn't shooting long distance shots that he didn't feel comfortable with. He was always, what I say, on balance. And defensively, he gave the effort. So he collectively, I thought,
for 20 or 24 of the Bulls' 45 points. I thought the Bulls
losers. Hogan's fires it to Rose. Shoots for three and hits. The shot clock rolling down. Rose had hit on in this third quarter. Here is Rose.
Oh.
Able to soar to find some
second half because the Bulls have kind of controlled the game. And Derrick Rose playing a really good all-around game, knocking down the three-point shot. And then look at this, just getting on the elevator, holding on.
Technical in the regular season. And here is Rose on the drive.
Oh, my goodness. Now
it's going to get LeBron James.
Look at this move right here. Just one dribble. And you think he's going to go up with his right hand. Switches to his left. Look at all the traffic around Derrick Rose.
Luol Deng is back playing with the four fouls. Here's Rose for three. Yes. 22 football tonight. Marines teamwork. Play of the game.
Well, with the injury to a sheet, Tom Thibodeau looking for answers off the bench. Kurt Thomas, Derrick Rose says he is the best screener on our team. With 16 years of experience, that pick and pop is going to be better.
2-5, we're just under 2 minutes remaining in the fourth. Rose spinning his way and scores! A sensational move by Derrick. The revitalized Bulls, sparked by all-star Derrick Rose in future.
And Stoudemire hook up early.
There's Gibson, he's given that open shot. Todd Gibson. In his second season out of University of Southern Cal, the first-round pick in rebounding, averaging 15 a game. He had 19 the other night. Here's Rose. How about Derrick Rose?
Hottest players in the NBA so far in this young season, finally getting out in transition, using that little crossover dribble to create some space and knock down that jumper.
First three games, Steve, Derrick Rose averaging just three. He's been a valuable guy off the bench. The Knicks are up. Oh! With the emphatic stuff.
Unbelievable. Off 2 feet. Puts it behind his head. About the only point guard in the league who can make that play.
Do you believe that's accurate? He can't palm the ball. Beautiful pass. Goes to Noah. The Knicks call for time, and Mike D'Antoni is very upset.
Well, the Knicks had played great defense until the last three or four possessions, and they lose the Bulls twice in transition, and then they let Derrick Rose get to the rim in one of the great dunks you will see all year.
Just under 2.5 left. First quarter, the game tied at 26.
Chance to build something.
They're up by 15 points. Rose with a nice lead pass. Noah with the bucket. He thought he was fouled. Here's Rose. Not able to put a move on Walker. Carver for three. Kyle Korver with the quick release, able to knock it down from the corner, and the Bulls are now within 10. Here's Rose, got the step. Oh, he backs it home. Derrick Rose.
Well, when Chicago has struggled this season, it's been Gibson can draw a foul possibly from Stoudemire.
Dang for three. Yes. Roel Dang coming off the career-high 40-point game.
Dunk. How about last year? Remember this one? I remember it very well. I didn't like this at all. In Phoenix, this pretty much sealed the game. I thought that was one of the highlight dunks of the year, and then he comes right back tonight and almost equals it.
Gibson. No, apparently it is a three. So it's a 20-point lead. Here's Rose for three. Gets it right back.
Now remember the World Championships this summer with Rose.
Lowry now defending on Rose. Finds the open man. It is Dang for three. And the Bulls showing some signs.
That was the pass. Thwarting these Bulls rallies.
It's a 9 of 13 from downtown. Here's Rose. Oh, what a move by Derrick Rose.
He is a highlight. Just ready to happen every single night.
Full shot.
They're right there. They just can't get over the hump.
16 turnovers by the Bulls. Rose with the runner. Derrick Rose turning it on here in the third quarter. 83-69. The Knicks on top.
Gibson, Dang, and Noah up front. Here's Rose again using his speed.
Well, he's going to try to take over. I mean, the Bulls now are bringing it defensively. This is their best lineup at the defensive end, and they're forcing.
Around Gallinari, but he lost it. Rose steps back to shoot.
Yes.
Just did beat the 24-second buzzer. A three-pointer for Rose. He scored the last 9 points for the Bulls.
Great New York holding off this furious Bulls rally. First, you see Derrick Rose
heaves for three. Noah with the rebound. Here's the pitch out. Two on one. Bogans with the finish.
And this is how Chicago has played the first few games of the season. Forced.
Derrick Collins with the call.
Now here's the rebound from Noah, and then the terrific outlet. What a tough angle. And Bogans running the floor. Perfect fast break there. Take a hard foul. Make Turioff make a couple free throws.
Rose twisting his way inside. What a move by Derrick Rose. 23 points, 12 assists. For Rose.
Just phenomenal body control. It's incredible when he leaps off to any of those long-range shots in the first half.
Dang open for three. Yes. And Rose made that play. Through the double, found the open man.
A la Steve Nash, working the baseline, kind of winding, weaving his way through the defense, and waiting for the open man to develop.
Goes back to their starting five here at the 7-minute mark of the second quarter. And Rose hits his first field goal of the season. Rose, Noah trying to get him cutting. Kept alive right back down the baseline. There goes the MVP, Derrick Rose.
How about the elevation
here in the NBA? Was taken with the first overall pick, and he's revitalized the Chicago Bulls franchise. Derrick Rose and the Bulls. Rose steps into a three, and that is a big addition to Derrick Rose's game last year. Percentage and volume won the units in Detroit.
Oh, absolutely.
Moves it right in. A three by Derrick Rose gives the Bulls their largest lead here in the first half on opening seven. It's been the best half of basketball of the three games so far. Rose from the top, got them all. A three for the MVP.
He had 29 in one and 30 in the other against the Lakers.
You see his three, then on the way back down, Joakim Noah picked up. Rebounded by Boozer. The Bulls will go with it. Rose, Dang in flight. And a foul.
That was great team play. He caught the clock. He then looked to the opposite side, and this guy really runs the lane well. And they're nice.
What are you doing to facilitate easy baskets for your teammates?
Just be more efficient. I think last year during the end, I wasn't even
by Noah. And Rose
for a triple. Got them all, Derrick Rose.
Now think about it. This guy broke in the league. He shot 22% his first year. And if they're going to continue to play him one-on-one, stay within 10 feet of the basket and work your inside game.
It'll run for the Lakers. Rose tries to end it with a triple. Boy. Derrick Rose has hit four of those here on Christmas opening day.
How about giving him four? He was way behind the line.
Now on Brewer. Here's the Rose three.
Just watch this as he now he's eating. Guys, he steps back.
Great cut and an excellent pass. Largest Laker lead in the game, 11. Rose to the basket. How did he do that? Derrick Rose hit the deck hard. Yeah, hit the back of his head.
He got hurt. You have 20 seconds on the shot clock.
Derek Fisher is in for LA. He's in the bottom right of your screen. They get it to Kobe right away. One trap for the steal. It's loose, and they got the steal. Will O'Dang with it. He came down, didn't travel. It's Rose, the MVP, with 11 seconds left. The Bulls with a chance to win here on Christmas Day. Rose left. Throws in the lane. Rose, good! Derek Rose and the Bulls come back to take a one-point lead.
Now that was great basketball strategy, great defensive strategy. They matched up with Blake in the backcourt. They knew that Kobe would get the ball. They double-teamed Kobe, and then they rotate Deng up to take away Gasol. Now this is just a great shot. Watch this shot up over the top of Gasol. That's a point guard shooting it up over a 7'2" guy with long arms.
What a shot.
That was an incredible shot. But the trap was the double team to give them the basketball in this situation. And this is an incredible shot by Derrick Rose up over the top.
He worked on that floater a lot this offseason. And here's Derrick Rose with
nothing. Wolves 1 of 5 to start. Derrick Rose.
You know, one of the things about D. Rose when they start the season.
And the Timberwolves have tied things up. Rose turns on the checks inside and rolls it in.
Wolves can shoot the three. They don't shoot that many of them, but they do shoot 38% time.
Rose breaks away from Ridnour and stuffs it. So clever. Derrick Rose, a lot of reasons he was the most valuable player in the NBA last season.
We've seen that same
look. Flip it in, nothing there. Here comes Rose. Derrick Rose, a race to the rim, flips it up and in. Great body control by Derrick Rose, who scores again.
Execution and great read by Wes Johnson on Newell Ding, jumping that wide angle screen.
Rose has got the three.
Shut him down, but in this ball game, it's been whatever he's wanted. Pick and roll game, jump shots. It's been easy pickings for everybody.
And the easy pickings continue as Rose on target again.
Yeah, they're just playing so easy right now. I can't wait for Marcel Wester to get back in uniform. Brad Miller, Malcolm Lee.
Taj Gibson continues the assault tonight. Bulls cooling down to 64% shooting. Rose stops and pops. Derrick Rose so quick for Williams, blocked by Taj Gibson. Korver loads up outside and hits the three.
This is what I'm saying. Derrick Williams has not figured out how to get his shot off. Now you're in the danger zone right now. There's still plenty of time left, but
Rose right up the middle, flips it up and in. Derrick Rose, one of the quickest in the NBA.
Right now, how come that's not delay of game?
Explosive move to the iron.
You got to sit Ricky Rubio down sometime.
The handle. Williams goes down for the loose ball. Taj Gibson collects it. Derrick Rose loads up from long range and drills it.
Derrick Williams has got to come up with that ball.
Derrick Rose, a burst to the baseline. A chic underneath. Rolls off the rim and in.
Without a plan, he's going to get you into trouble.
Rose explodes to the rim. Derrick Rose.
Rubio have been Minnesota's two best players tonight, no question. For a lot of different reasons.
Rose stops and pushes it home.
Just so cold-blooded, Derrick Rose.
Corner. A sheet. Grabs the loose ball. Derrick Rose takes care of business. The long three for the defending MVP. 11 assists, and he's knocked down four threes.
Checks the shot clock at the other end of the floor. The other shot by Dent didn't hit the rim, so it had to get up, and he checks the shot clock and just makes a cold-blooded play.
Rodeo road trip and the All-Star break, and look who's in town. Derrick Rose, the reigning MVP, and the Chicago Bulls having another great season, as are the Spurs.
And when Noah's active like he has been in this recent play, as Rose makes a nice defensive play, the Bulls are hard to beat.
And Rose again playing good defense as Parker and the Spurs turn it over.
That's just great timing by Derrick Rose contesting.
Calf injury. He won't play tonight for San Antonio. Manu Ginobili is still out. Rose elevates over the defense and lofts it in. What a play.
This is just, you can't teach it. The ability to stop, elevate, and shoot the little floater. Parker's not a three-point shooter, but Anderson, Bonner, and Neal are. Good cut by Rose.
Nice find by Deng. One-point game.
Rose and split the team. Good cut here by Rose on the little.
Duncan off the underside of the front of the rim. He's now 0 for 5. Derrick Rose is down and holding his right knee. Derrick Rose is injured behind the play. And again is reaching for his right knee. Knee on knee collision with Parker.
A lot of padding like football players do, lightweight padding that hopefully can minimize some of that impact.
I guess he's okay. 11 and Parker with 8. Rose sustaining a knee injury but bounced back, stayed in the game. Bulls have not been able to get any looks for Korver since he checked in. Rose taking matters into his own hands in spectacular fashion.
Incredible strength by Derrick Rose.
Korver. Final 2 minutes here with the first half. Rose. Three-pointer Derrick Rose. Chicago with its largest lead of the game. Derrick Rose makes a three. 16 points for Rose. Chicago by 8. Antonio in the second quarter belonging to the visitors from Chicago. Noah with a nice half. Derrick Rose with a game high 16. The Bulls lead the Spurs by 8.
Rose started it off with a good little running floating shot from 8 feet and then took the injury scare with the knee to knee. 5 hit from the floor, 2 for 3 from 3, and then Rose came back in. And this is what I love about his game. His ability to take contact and still finish. And then even though he's a third, overpower people in the low post, so he's shooting a lot more jump shots and has really improved in that area.
Boozer into traffic. How did he get that off the glass and in?
Run on the floor. Sometimes they get beat uncharacteristically down for easier baskets.
Rose the penetration and the scoop and a foul as well.
Wow. Crosses over. Attacks Duncan, splits the defense, and gets hit on the shoulder.
Good finish. Final minute of the third. Rose a little stop and go. 1-point game. Derrick Rose having a big night. 23 points to lead all scorers. But it.
They broke it.
That was a. I bet you he bragged on that day. Wow. Rose can brag about that, can he? Dang the screen. Korver open for a three. Finally, Kyle Korver gets a look, and Chicago's up by 5.
Get Korver free, but it started with this crossover attack. Beautiful left-hand finish with a little contact. And then the delivery by Rose, wide open. Korver knocks it down, Bulls up 5 for the Spurs.
Deng for 3. Huge shot for the Bulls.
Deng setting the screen has led to great shots all night long. Good play by Rose to put it right in Deng's challenge. 21 shots. and he's gotten them in different ways. The spin out and back cut, the adjustment to the left hand, and then this one where he takes the contact on, keeps his balance, and then the beautiful use of the rim and the left hand finish.
And Neal now has the Spurs last 13 points. Rose gets it to go. 27. Noah doesn't want the shot. Rose will take it and hit it.
For the pull up. Started here. The ability to, you can't describe that. That's too good. And then the Duncan right hand drive with the running hook.
Worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com. Here, NBA, the Chicago Bulls, led by the reigning MVP, Derrick Rose. Hi, everybody, and welcome. Rose, relatively speaking, held in check by the 76ers in a game number one last month as Boozer knocks down the jumper. And Boozer down with the rebound for the Bulls. Friends, minutes and numbers are down this year, and there's exactly what the game plan says. Don't let him do. Don't let Rose get to the paint, get to his right hand, but of course, Doris, much easier said than done.
Yeah.
Good start as well. Holiday just 21 years of age. Rose is only 23. He's already won an MVP. What a play.
Paper at times.
Probably could score more if he wanted to, but filling a variety of roles on this team. It's a very balanced Philadelphia team with six and double figures. Derrick Rose buries a three.
And that's the change in his game. And now he's an impossible check, right? I mean, they're used to him. He's able to get between, okay? You want to force him left. Instead, he gets right, and he goes right between three bodies. And how about the English on that shot?
Rose today tipped away, got it back. Rose, another wide open three. Down 10 already, including a couple of threes and a spectacular layup. Aggressive and very good in the early going.
Now it's so difficult to guard off the dribble drive, especially to his right hand. His strength and ability to adjust in the air, the athleticism is there. Drew Holiday, he thinks he's looking to pass it out. He just plays with great pace. This is where they're playing inside out. You don't necessarily need to enter it into the post for a shot opportunity. Just collapse the defense enough to give him good looks.
Numbers down, as we mentioned. He's into his 30s now, playing fewer minutes, and he's averaging career lows in scoring and rebounding, but off to a good start tonight. Rose again, high off the glass and in.
Extraordinary. And he's got, you know, there's a reason the guy's successful.
5 seconds. Rose trying to get away from Turner. And a beautiful feed onto the baseline. Brewer with the reverse.
Drains a shot. He's got to be able to do that. And after a couple of...
trying to force him left. How do they do?
Well, I mean, obviously, explosive speed gets him between bodies and to that right hand quite often. And there's a reason that they're good defensively, Philadelphia. Yes, you're going to get by staying with your...
Noah gives it right back to Rose. 4 seconds. The switch. Thaddeus Young on him. Rose gets it off and hits it. It is a two-pointer, a long two for Derrick Rose. His only points of the second quarter, but a big basket for the Bulls going into halftime.
His ability, when you get him going left, it's a little bit better. But this was the only basket he had in that second period, a big one.
Boozer looking for help. Shot clock down to five. Boozer got it. Midway through the third. Feels like more, but it's a six-point game with all the struggles the Bulls have had. Now it's four as Hamilton knocks it down. The assist to Rose. Who's the rebound? Rose driving right by Brand and one.
And just he's mixing speeds now. He's just thinking about it. And look, just that moment's hesitation to freeze Brand, make him think he's going to back it out. And great strength. I mean, you're giving up some size there. How many times have we seen him on those drives put the ball off the window?
Rose. Oh. Iguodala on Rose. Young on Korver. Rose. Got another one.
another long two, just as he did at the end of the first half. 25 points, 6 assists, and a buzzer beater for the end of the second and the third, and a jumper to begin the fourth. Remember, C.J. Watson, 27 points, 7 assists. Nice look, a wide open Dang. Got it. Another three for Dang.
Well, that's right. It's about three times now. Doug Collins has looked down his bench and said, bad shot.
Another three. Unbelievable. Rose, what a shot. He has made remarkable shot after remarkable shot in this game. This has not been an easy, if there is such a thing, 35-point game. The degree of difficulty is about as high as it could get.
Yeah, they have guarded him big. They've trapped him. Look at the two guys coming at him, but he just stays with the left hand. I mean, listen, if you're going to concede one direction, you concede that direction, and they're forcing him that way. I don't think Young wants to give up the drive, but how about that? Falling away, no balance. Remember, we talked about physical strength with Derrick Rose. Freaky athleticism, both in play on this possession. How about that?
He is tied a season high with 35 points. In the background on the last replay, you could see Evan Turner's 96-91 in a spirited game tonight at the Wells Fargo.
Derrick Rose has torched the Bucks with over 25 points a game this season.
Well, he will, and of course, you do not stop Derrick Rose. Derrick Rose is, as you said, Jim, the MVP. That makes him the best in the league. It's impossible to contain him. You have to try. The best penetrator we've seen in years, and there are a lot of great penetrators in the game today and ones that have played. The Bucks will try to wall off on him and do as good a job as they can containing him. Try to keep him on the perimeter. You hope he misses
against Philadelphia on Monday. He'll have a tougher time tonight against Derrick Rose, and you see that he will have a tougher time staying between Derrick Rose and the basket. Rose is lightning quick.
One of the most explosive players I've ever seen.
But 6 out of 11.
To
blow you away for the pick in the last game.
Thank you. No, I tell you, Carlos in the last 7 games has been shooting 26%.
Time he comes out of games, over 16 points a game.
And the last game here, Jim, of course, they just took over from the tip in that one.
That man did, Derrick Rose.
Yep. Play up because the Bulls typically, Jim, they don't sink. They don't, you know, go up and down, spike up and down. They're very steady, and they come at you with so many ways. There's an example. So many weapons, and they're extremely.
Rose inside. You must keep him out of the paint as much as possible.
Right. And it's impossible.
Right. This time, 12 points on 5 of 7 shooting.
Well, nothing new here, huh, Jim? You just like to try to keep him on the perimeter. Now, he threw that one up kind of at a buzzer, and it was a clinker. But look at these shots he makes, and he does it every night. And that's what I was talking about when I said 46% shooting. You see, he's in the land of the Giants. He's banged. He's hit. He's got a challenge. He's got a corkscrew. Well, plus, you know, Noah really has no offense for him. So once in a while, he gets to do that and pays off. Whoa!
I think Rose just made a statement.
He's quick. He can hang time. Brandon tries to get him up and get body into him, but Rose is something else. Didn't work. But it was a runner to the basket.
Back to Rose from Brewer. Chicago had a 9-point lead in the first half. The Bucks at 1 point up by 3. Dang. Have turned it over against Milwaukee in this series. They get an easy basket from Noah, 16 in the fourth quarter. 89-85. Bang.
He is money on the baseline.
Tipped out to Rose. Back to help out Dunleavy.
A burst by Chicago.
That is called attacking the basket. That's what he does.
26 for Derrick Rose.
He's tremendous in the floor, open floor like this. How many people?
27 points for Drew Gooden under the two-minute mark. Bang for three.
That's a big hurt right there. If you hold him there, you got something to work with. They are a good offensive rebounding team. They're going to give it to Rose and let him work. Guess what? I don't know if they'll go high screen or clear out again.
Nobody's showing. They're letting him work.
Yep.
6 seconds. Down to four. Now he's going to go.
He's going to pull up for a jumper, huh?
And win the game.
Is that the first jumper he made tonight? I think it is.
Now this is reviewable, of course. It was called good on the court. It has to be upheld. We will be. Derrick Rose gets to 30. Shot for the victory. 106-104 to sweep the four-game season series with the Bucks. Well, what a finish. A lot to talk about tonight on Bucks Live.
Is the reigning MVP in the NBA, and Mike, he had a dagger last night against the Milwaukee Bucks. A game-winning shot, really the first significant game-winning shot of his career, truly right at the buzzer, which gave Chicago the two-point win. Anderson just picked up his first personal foul for the Orlando Magic. Otis Smith, the GM, trying to make the move. Here is Boozer with a good feed on the perimeter.
Anderson went, tried to front him, but he fronted him. Just look at what he does for this team and what he's done to get him where they are in the standings right now. You have to consider him.
Nelson, by the way, with four. Here's a triple launched by Rose.
Almost like he heard us talking about it.
We don't have that motor that we need.
Listen, they played Washington, Milwaukee, and Toronto. In all three games, we've seen the drop-down pass to Noah for the finish. All three of those explode and get you 25, 30 points on a given night.
Richardson is healthier, so he's making even a better effort on defense, too. They say Williams with a left hand, reeling down the lane.
Surprise me.
Richardson came out and closed well.
We saw more passes there in 3 seconds than most teams throw in a quarter of a game.
How about Gibson off the bench with a quick four? Noah, who's such a good passer in the middle of the floor, off to Rose with the suction move. Derrick Rose has gone. Nelson kicked away by Howard, literally. Rose, good if it goes. Yes! The Bulls end the first half on a 15-3 run.
How deflating have the last minute and a half been for the Orlando Magic as they go in at the half? You knew after watching last night and the look in his eye, this one was going in.
Rose with 10, beating the buzzer. And Chicago down by 5. 2010. Lost the starting job to Bogans, who is gone, and they signed Rip Hamilton in the offseason. Again, it's two guys. Good shot by Derrick Rose. 5-13. Under two to play here in the third. Duhon watching Rose. Gibson into Howard. Josh Gibson is off the bench, and the 5-4 Chicago. Noah the screen. Crossover by Rose. Rose is 16. Absolutely. Look at this. 0 of 8 this quarter when shooting for the lead or a tie for the Bulls. Boozer for the lead. The reigning MVP, Derrick Rose, leads his hometown Bulls. Every game this season for Chicago. He's had all kinds of injuries through his career. Great feed. Boozer into Rose. Boozer, who averaged 15 points a game this season, a little below his career average, but his overall game is at right now the best. We cannot get behind early against this team at home.
And we talked about all the injuries to the Chicago Bulls. It doesn't look like they've lost a lot of that chemistry with that starting unit.
Scoring last season at 15 points a game.
Rip Hamilton again. Digging his way to the basket. Iguodala couldn't make it go. Chicago hasn't scored in 3 minutes. Rose from Hamilton. Matchup with those two and then final round before the finals. And the other way, it is Hamilton. What a great pass. Basically the length of the floor by Derrick Rose. 13 points for Hamilton. They had a little bit of a trough. It looks like they're pulling themselves out of it.
No, a year ago, there's no way Ronnie Brewer makes that play.
For Brand and Turner and Holiday. Right inside. Derrick Rose. Pedal to the metal. 6 point.
At receiving the basketball and getting the ball out of his hand.
So had a screen for Rose and shimmies his way free. And puts in another.
Someone like Elton Brand may have played in this building before.
He feels comfortable. Here's Rose the other way. Derrick Rose beginning to heat up right now. Caught a little fire here in the second quarter.
Man, we were wondering, was there going to be a little bit of rust? And look at the quick move, misdirection there on Turner to get into the paint. And here's that teardrop floater we talked about once he gets into that paint area. Well, that third ball handler on the floor for the Sixers, which has turned out to be Turner, is allowing Holiday to be more creative offensively and just run the floor.
Hamilton coming out. Holiday had an older brother who played at the University of Washington. Williams all played UCLA. Rose, a three. Now Derrick Rose has turned the key. The ignition is on, and he's got 15 for Chicago.
And they end up having the best overall record in the NBA this year and have a chance to win a championship.
Here's Dang, a right-handed shooter. Iguodala moments ago picked up his third. Here's a three. Rose. He is putting his foot on the gas here in the third quarter. Derrick Rose right there, and that is a foul on Boozer number two.
Well, when you start knocking this down and you're Derrick Rose, there's no way you can guard him because he's going to get by you because of his quickness. And when he's got that three-point shot clicking like he does tonight, very tough cover.
Rose, the rookie of the year, sliding inside. Korver teeing up a three. Picks up number one for the Sixers.
Let's hear the vision of Derrick Rose. See all the red jerseys that converge as he gets into the paint area, which allows Korver that wide open three-point look for the Sixers all season. Most of their scoring comes from their bench player.
Two to shoot. Rose outside, puts it in. Better shooting from him. Noah just picked up his second personal foul. 2.5 to play. Rose, like I said, closing in on a triple-double. He's got 23.
Exactly what you're supposed to do because the Bulls are trying to send a message and a knockout punch that, look, we're looking to sweep you guys. You wanted us. You were crying out that you bypassed the harder team in Miami.
Oh, Rose came down bad on his left foot. See him holding onto his knee. Holding on to his knee and down. He was flying and he came down wrong on the left foot. Now whether it was an ankle or a knee, I do not know. Yes, Coach Collins out there and all his teammates running. And this, with the injury, we just talked about the 26 games he has missed with an assortment of injuries and now holding a knee late in a game that is already decided for all intents and purposes.
And I'm sure everyone around the country is going to say, why was he in the game?
Let's see how he comes down on the left leg. Keep an eye on the left leg there. Yep, when he planted, that's when whatever happened. Let's see here.
Yeah, it's before he comes down. It's the plant right there on that left leg.
There was some give. There was some give on that knee, and you could see it.
Looked like it went in, too.
That's what I'm saying.
Oh, you never want to see this. This is a guy that...
How about one guy, one injury, changing...
Everything.
Not only this series, but, I mean, the landscape of the Eastern Conference and perhaps beyond, if it is...
If it is serious enough for him to miss time. I will say this. They're used to playing without Derrick Rose this year as well.
Yeah, without Rose, they are 18-9. With him, 32-7. But they're doing the kinds of things now with his legs that obviously they got to be thorough, but he looking to see his facial expression,
a collective
the kind of pain he's in.
Gas oh. has just come over everyone in this building, including us.
Wow. Well, the procedure now will be immediately.
Holding onto his knee and down.